Hi, I'm Frank Worth. I'm with the University of Maine Cooperative Extension. We're here to talk to you today about growing your own seedlings indoors so we can get a jump on the season here in Maine. And we're going to show you how to grow them under lights as opposed to in a sunny window where folks often run into trouble. And we can save a lot of money by using some simple materials. And I'm going to show you a model today that I've come up with that you might want to copy. And we have plans for this right here on our website. And so we've just got a few materials here. I wanted to show it like this because it could be easily stored away for the non-growing season and not take up much space. So let me put this together for you. A lot of home gardeners will grow seedlings in a south-facing window, but here in Maine and throughout the north, you just don't get enough light. Also at night, it's cold and they get stressed during the evening, and you end up with these weak, foliated seedlings reaching to the light that are just gonna not produce a good plant and will be likely to break out in the garden. It's great to use a cordless drill and sheetrock screws because then you could take these things apart for storage. But using 1x3 strapping is very inexpensive. Platform here is just leftover lumber that I had around, but you could use anything. These are hooks you can get at any hardware store and are basically here to hold our lights. Again, the plans for this frame are on our website and it's very simple to put together. The advantage of this frame is it's going to end up as a double decker, one set of lights up here, and then room for expansion for another set of lights down below. The lights that you want to use for these are the very inexpensive shop lights that you get at any hardware store. And they come with these chains already attached and with a plug strip. And so you're just going to hang them from your hooks, and you can adjust the height of those as your plants grow. Kind of bulbs you could use, I tend to use just cool white, although a lot of people will like to mix cool white and warm white because it gives a wider spectrum of wavelength of light that plants grow best under. But cool white seems to work just fine for me. You want to adjust the lights so that they're essentially 4 to 6 inches from the top of the canopy of your plants, which is why using these adjustable chains is great. You can raise and lower them as the plants grow. Two other things you'll need is a plug strip and an inexpensive timer because you want to run your lights 16 hours a day. This is going to ultimately accommodate 4 flats, and a lot of people will run just 2 grow lights, but I find that you get a little bit more light intensity and better plant growth with 3 sets. Early on in the season, you'll want to start with the upper deck. And during that time, you can store your watering can, your fertilizers, your seeds, your other paraphernalia on the lower level. But at some point, you're going to fill this whole area up, and then you're going to get a second set of 3 lights hanging down below, and you will expand and eventually occupy the double decker full of seedlings. More than enough for the average home gardener.